So you want to be sexy? Get a blue marker pen, some beer, and red lipstick. And yes, guys, the lipstick's for you too. Statistically speaking, if you're watching this, you're male. So I'll start off with how you chaps can attract the ladies. Firstly, take a blue marker pen and colour in your forehead. Scientist Johnson et al. Found that this will really help you pick up the chicks. Literally. They coloured the foreheads of male blue tits in light blue marker pen and found that the females fed their chicks much more than the chicks that had been, than the males that had been coloured in dark blue. Why? Because light blue reflects more UV, which is really attractive to those lady blue tits. When you're done with your blue marker pen, you need to get some long feathers and stick them to yourself. In what has become a classic experiment, Anderson found that by adding long feathers to the tails of widow birds to make them longer, the males had much higher reproductive success. And not forgetting the ladies, if you want to attract a male, you're gonna need some beer. Or more importantly, to look like an orange beer bottle. Male Australian jewel beetles are so attracted to orange dimply things that they nearly sent themselves to extinction by mating with orange dimply beer bottles instead of females of their own species. So why are these three examples interesting? Well, they're all supernormal stimuli, which are fascinating and surprisingly ubiquitous phenomena. The animals all showed a stronger response to the artificial, exaggerated stimuli, the marker pen, the longer feathers and the beer bottle, than they do to normal, natural stimuli. Nico Tinbergen, the founding father of behavioural biology, or ethology, famously discovered these stimuli in the 1950s when he noticed that oyster catchers would prefer to sit on abnormally large eggs, even large eggs of other species rather than their own eggs when given the chance. And he also found that male sticklebacks, which are very territorial, would completely ignore a realistic model which didn't have a red belly, but would aggressively fight over their territory for models that did have a bright red belly, but looked nothing like a fish. If, as I claim, the answer to nearly everything is evolution, then how does a beetle ignoring its own species in favour of a beer bottle help evolutionarily? Or a bird sitting on eggs of the wrong species just because they're bigger? Well, the answer is that all of these are artificial scenarios to which the species simply haven't evolved, and therefore the responses just aren't adaptive. Under normal circumstances, the algorithm sit on the largest egg will be adaptive because larger eggs produce healthier chicks. And you don't normally have scientists running around sticking eggs of the wrong species into your nest, so the algorithm doesn't have to be any more accurate than that. Evolution isn't an intelligent designer, and organisms aren't perfectly designed. They simply have to be as good as they need to be in the environments they experience. Humans aren't immune to supernormal stimuli either. If anything, we're worse. We adapted to hunting and foraging in the African plains, once described as a camping trip that lasts your entire lifetime, which means that virtually everything around us is an unnatural stimulus to which we apply our primal urges. Red lipstick on women both makes the lips look fuller and plumper, signs of youth and fertility, and also redder, a sign of arousal. And push-up bras? Well, you get the picture. And it's not restricted to sex. Deirdre Barrett gave a great talk on and wrote a not-so-great book, starts to read a bit like a self-help book, all about supernormal stimuli, and both illustrate just how pervasive they are in human culture. As humans, we not only respond to the supernormal stimuli using our original instincts, but we turn it on its head and create even more exaggerated stimuli just to satisfy our primal urges. Why are things cute? Well, watch Vsauce's video about how big eyes and large heads signify youth and help us protect and look after our young. But now we produce ever cuter teddy bears and cartoon characters to satisfy our original evolutionary instincts. I mentioned in one of my earlier videos why we like sweet and fatty foods in order to consume enough calories, but now we produce chocolate and cake to satisfy these original evolutionary instincts. We crave human contact and friendship, but now we play multiplayer video games, or we watch YouTube to get to know our favourite YouTubers, all to satisfy our original evolutionary instincts. Dan Dennett puts it in an interesting way in one of his talks. Take anything that we find enjoyable, be that sugar, sex, friendship, and comedy, and you can ask,
what hard job that has to be done, it's dirty work, somebody's got to do it, is so important to give us such a powerful inbuilt reward for it when we succeed?
Thanks for watching this Shed Science. If you enjoyed it, it would really help me out if you could share it on Twitter, Tumblr, Facebook, Reddit, whatever Reddit is and does. And I'll leave Flanders and Swan to play us out with a rather apt extract from The Armadillo. Oh, and that red lipstick for guys? Rub it on your belly and pretend to be a stickleback. Keep smiling.
Oh, my darling armadillo, how delightful it would be if for us those silver wedding bells would chime. Let the orange blossom billow if you'll only say I will. Oh, be my darling armadillo all the time. Then I saw them in a hollow by a yellow muddy bank, an armadillo singing to an armor-plated tank. Should I tell it? Gaunt and rusting with a willow tree above, this, abandoned on manoeuvres, is the object of your love. I left it to its singing, cycled home without a pause. Never tell someone the truth about the one that he adores.